In 2016, the top earner in the Northern Pike Minnow Sports Reward Program cashed checks totaling nearly $120,000. Plus, that person saved a whole lot of salmon and steelhead smolt from being eaten by the Northern Pike Minnow. Now let's join Cameron Black and his son Layden for a little lesson on how you can get started in catching these predatory fish and put some more money in your bank.
So there's a lot of Northern Pike Minnow up inside these tributaries, but the boundary zones for these areas are 400 feet up into the river's mouths, which is where you're going to be able to catch Pike Minnow to turn in for reward. So, you know, we got to head out to the Columbia or at least stay within 400 feet of all these tributary mouths. So it looks like a little bit windy today. I think we're going to just head up river and try some of these coves that are going to be protected by this point, just to kind of get out of the wind. Sometimes it's real hard to like detect bites and to keep your bait from snagging up on the bottom if you're swinging around a lot. So we're just going to go find an easy place to fish and see what we can do. So pike minnows are a predatory fish, but they also don't sit necessarily out in the main stem of the Columbia River down here where we're fishing. Where this area is, it's a lot of sand and it's a lot of hardpan, and the fish don't have any kind of cover. So like up by the dams where there's like big boulders and big drop-offs and stuff, they'll sit behind those little softer areas, even with the current flowing fast overhead, and pick off those smolt. And so this particular spot is just on the edge of a nice current. It's gonna be about 8 to 10 feet deep, and we're just gonna see if there's anything in here. So a basic setup is just gonna be a sliding weight, and you always wanna make sure you have enough weight that you're gonna be anchored on the bottom. If you have a little bit of lead, especially fishing these areas, you're gonna move around, you're gonna end up snagging up. So I just have a little protector bead, a little swivel, and then about 10 to 12 pen test line. And the most basic bait for a northern pike minnow is just a little bait, a little ball of worms, but salmon guts, chicken liver, especially like fresh salmon roe, are really effective baits for this lower river fishery. You can see him casting a side drift rig steelhead. And so what I'm using is just a P-Line FluoroClear leader. I use this a lot for steelhead, so I had it in the boat, but honestly, these fish aren't too line shy, but you still want to have a good quality leader because these fish can end up being, you know, 3, 4, 5 pounds. So you never know what you're gonna hook into out here. So down here, you know, there's a lot of P-mouth and a lot of minnows and stuff like that that'll pick at your bait. But generally, since the pike minnow are kind of predatory, it seems like that when you do get a pike minnow bite, they tend to grab it pretty good and pretty fast, and they tend to try to inhale it. So generally, if you're getting into an area where you're just getting a lot of little ticks, a lot of little bites, you might not be in an area that has necessarily a lot of pike minnow in it, but it might have a lot of the pea mouths and the other little minnows that will sit there and pick your bait.
I got one.
Oh, you got a little perch there, buddy. Here, let's see that one.
Perch.
Yep. So actually, that's a pretty good sized perch, but
you see that's just not... like our old fish we had, crappie and perch.
Crappie and perch. Yeah, so you're going to catch a lot of, like, especially using worms out here, you're going to catch a lot of these kind of fish. You're going to catch a lot of like smallmouth bass, perch. You can catch some crappies, but a lot of times if you're into, like the crappies and some of the backwater fish, you're not going to be in the area that the pike minnow are at. Perch, though, they kind of hang out everywhere, so we're going to just let him go.
Can we keep fishing?
Yeah. So there's two reasons to fish this Northern Pike Minnow program. I mean, one obviously is to help save the salmon. You know, when we built the dams and stuff like that in the Columbia, we've slowed up the river, and basically it helped the pike minnow and it hurt the salmon. Contrary to popular belief, the pike minnow are native fish to this Columbia River. So it's not something that I think the program is necessarily trying to kill off, but it's just something they're trying to manage. But the second reason too is to make money. A lot of guys, there's the guys that are making six figures in 6 months on this project. You know, the 1 to 25 pays $5 a fish, 25 to 200 pays $6 a fish, and 200 and up pays $8 a fish for a fish over 9 inches. So there's some guys making some serious bank. I mean, they're putting in the time and they're putting in the work, but there's some pretty good opportunity to make some extra money doing this.
For rules, regulations, fishing advice and instructions, and locations of check-in stations, visit pikeminnow.org. Cameron and Layden Black are showing us how to get started in making money catching northern pike minnow. But in this spot, we're only catching perch, so it's time to move, which is a big key to success.
So if we were real serious about catching pike minnow, another couple things these guys do is they always tend to follow the fish. You know, there's some of the pools definitely produce fish at different times of years. So like at the start of the season in May, you know, up towards the Dalles and stuff can be very productive. But down here, this area doesn't generally heat up until a little later on. I'm talking below Bonneville, until July and August. So, you know, if you follow the fish, you got to fish at night. And a lot of times, you know, concentrating around where those dams and where those smolts are getting flushed through, those are the areas that the guys that are making the real good bucks are finding to be productive.
I lift it up and I felt like a bump.
Don't lift it up. Remember, you don't lift. You set it. If you feel a peak at the fish, you set it.
So what I was telling Layden there is if, you know, you get a bite, you know, let them kind of bite it. You know, you want them to take it. So if it swallows it, you're probably going to have a lot better chance of hooking them. So since we're kind of fishing in the area, there's a lot of smaller pike minnows. We're just using a size one hook, but, you know, using, you know, anything from a size four to a size one aught are generally what you want. So another thing about the pike minnow program is you have to register every day and you have to bring the fish back fresh every day. And so when the Columbia is at 70 degrees, and you know, fortunately we're cloudy today, but it can be really warm, your fish have to be in a fresh, cool condition. So I always throw the ice in the Yeti and that's going to absolutely keep them stone cold till I turn them in. So we can sit here and catch more perch, or we're going to just try to move. You know, we've been here just a little bit, but we're not into them. So we're going to just keep moving to find them. You know, so we're trying to find these fish. We're trying to draw them into our baits. I know ProCure makes a Nightcrawler super gel too. And so like if you're trying to draw these fish in and they're just kind of broadcasted over an area, never hurts to have a little scent on there. Go live in. You got them.
No, you don't.
Keep reeling.
Hey, this, I can play with it.
Oh, that's pike minnow there. There you go.
Hey.
I know, we don't want to lose them. That one, that's actually what we're after. There you go, hold on to that for a second.
Me?
Yeah, hold the line just for a second. I gotta reel this other one in. Okay, so that's a northern pike minnow right here. You can tell it's northern pike minnow because it doesn't have any of the red stripes like the pea mouths do in the lower river. And it also has a really big mouth, you know, for the size of the fish. And that's what it's gonna be doing when it gets a little bit bigger and starts eating salmon smolts. So that's kind of what we're after. He's just a little guy, but you know, we can catch a lot of perch, catch a lot of stuff, just goofing off and having fun. But that's what you're wanting. That's what you're looking for. Okay, so it's real windy today in this part of the river, and I'm not really necessarily finding a lot of pike minnow, but one thing good about the pike minnow program is there's lots of resources at pikeminnow.org, and you're able to, you know, for people that are just trying to get into it, there's lots of information out there. You know, they do want these fish caught. They want, you know, these pike minnow to be limited so we get more salmon out. So there's a lot of good information out there. You can also call down to the Region 5 office and, you know, for a WDFW. And you know, give those guys a chatting too, and they'll be able to keep you more in line with like what's going on as far as like the current fishing reports and where the hot bite is. So good luck out there.
Hey, thanks for watching today's episode. You know, without the support of the sponsors, the show would not be possible. So please thank them when you can. Now, get out there and do some great fishing.